Hey savvy people, it's Savvy Nick here, and today we'll be going through how to use aliases in Bash Shell using Linux. I have Ubuntu 20.04 running here, but you can use this on any Linux distribution that you want as long as you're running some form of shell. So what this will help us do is make commands very simple for us to use so we don't have to constantly remember them. Instead, we can create a shorter alias for them and reference that alias to run the command. So by default, Ubuntu actually has some aliases already predefined on the system. So we can check those out just by typing in alias and then space dash p, press enter, and here you can see just the few aliases that they have. So by default, if you type ls, it actually uses ls dash dash color equal auto. And that's just for a coloring scheme here. But instead of having to type this every time, all you do is type in ls, and then the system recognizes, hey, you actually want to run this entire command here. So the same thing goes for the ones above. Again, if you run grep, it just runs a fancier version of the grep with color. That way you don't just get white text. Okay, so how do we add our own alias to the system here? Well, that's fairly simple. So let's go ahead and add in our first alias. And if you're new and stopping by to watch a video today, please make sure to subscribe below and hit that notification bell for more Linux and programming videos. All right, we'll type alias again and then put a space. Following that, we're going to go ahead and create our own command. You can call it whatever you want, but it might make sense to have it somewhat similar to the command that you're going to be aliasing. So in this one, I'm going to do df, which is already a command in the system, and it stands for disk free, and it just displays the free disks on the system. So if I just did df, you can see here that you get all my current disks on the system, but there's actually something else that I like running, df-h, which in my opinion is a little better here. It gets rid of the blocks and just shortens up some of the numbers here, so it's easier for me to read. So I always use df-h, so this is a perfect one to go ahead and alias. So back to the aliasing, we were writing alias, and then we're gonna put a space, and then I'm gonna use df, and I'm gonna put an equal sign. Now, right of this equal sign, we're going to put single quotes, and in between those single quotes, we'll write out the command that we actually wanna run when we run df. So if I type in df, put a space, dash h is what I wanted to go ahead and run. Now I'm going to press enter, and now I can go ahead and print out the aliases again to make sure that mine took. And right here it says it did take. So if I type in df this time, we can see that the new df alias has been aliased to df space dash h, and it actually printed out the version of df that I like the best. Now this is great if you want to just temporarily have an alias command, but you have to go one step further and edit the init file that runs. So for bash, that's the bash rc file located in the home users directory. And since we're here in the home users directory, if I type pwd, you can see home, savvy nick, my user, I can go ahead and open up bash rc. I'm going to use nano in order to do that and just type in dot bash rc. Now, if you're using zsh instead of using bash, you can also open up the zsh rc file. It should be in the same location, just a different file. So since I'm using bash, I'm going to open this one up, and we can see that some stuff already exists in this file. So I'm going to the bottom here with nano, and one thing I'll show you is up above here, you'll see some more aliases written. So we can actually add ours right here if we want, just to keep things in line here with how Ubuntu has their bash rc file set up. And if you went ahead and made it this far, please hit the like button. It really does help me out. So why not? I'm going to go ahead and place it here underneath alias l. Now you can look into what these switches actually do here for listing files, but if you use ll, it does run this. If you use la here in Ubuntu, ls space dash capital A gets ran. So I'm going to go ahead add my own alias in, and this one is again df, and I'm just going to default that one instead to df dash h. But why stop there? I'm going to actually put in a few more that I like to do. How about alias update? I'm gonna set that equal to sudo apt update, so that way I don't have to type all of this in. Instead, it'll get typed in for me every time I type in update, and then I can go ahead enter my password in, and boom, my system repos get updated. Next, I'll do alias inst for install, and I'll do sudo apt install for this one. This will help me install applications by simply typing INST, and we'll actually have to supply one extra thing after that, so I'll show you when we run that one. But it just makes it a little quicker to go ahead and install a package here in Ubuntu for me. Another one I like using is an alias called HS. And HS, what that does for me is it does a history search. So if I type in history, and I'm going to pipe that over to grep, this will allow me to go ahead and display the contents of history, pass it over to grep, and then grep will be able to search through that history based on whatever I give the console. And one last one I'll do is alias rd for remove directory. And all that is remove rm space dash r, and then I can type my directory name. All right, after I have all this done, I can go ahead and write the file by exiting, and I just have to press Control X, and then it's going to ask me to save the modified buffer here in Nano. I'm going to go ahead and type in yes or Y, and then what name I want to write it out to, well, bashrc is the file that I want to write it out to. After I'm done with that, what I'll do is run source.bashrc just to go ahead and update the shell so it knows my new aliases I just added. And now I'm going to go ahead and print out and make sure those aliases have populated. And they sure have. So the first one I'm going to run is, let's do INST, and then I'm going to install the Vim package. And now I'm being asked, hey, what's your password for your super user? And I'm going to put that password in. Give it a few moments and see how it's now installing Vim for me. And all I had to put is INST and then the package name behind it. It's just a nice and easy way to go ahead and not have to remember all the switches and or extra commands behind a specific command. It can really help condense things if you have a really long command. So let's go ahead and print our aliases out one more time. So we also added in sudo apt update by just typing update. So you can see it starts updating my repositories here and reading in package lists. And the system's telling me there's now 110 packages that can be upgraded. So if we go and use df again, we can see that it's using the df-h form that I wanted it to use. And this is the one I use the most. So I'm happy that I have that now available for me by just using df. All right, and another one I did was hs, which is the history search. And something that I typed in before for a command was alias, so why not look that up? And here's all the times that I've typed in alias in my history, and I have the number of when it occurred in history. So if I wanted to rerun something, let's say the last time alias showed up was in the hs alias command, so I just rerun 18, and there you go. But if we look back here and we look at hs, HS is much easier to write out than history and then a pipe and a grep followed by what you're actually searching for. The last one we haven't used is RD to remove a directory. So I don't like to have to type in dash R. Instead, I just remember RD for remove directory instead of just RM. And if I wanted to remove a directory, let's say remove directory like downloads, I can do that just by typing rd and then followed by what directory I want to remove, and you can see that downloads has now disappeared. Aliasing could be a very powerful tool here in Linux and can help you save time running commands by simplifying them. So make sure to go ahead and check it out for yourselves. There is one last command that you can use, and that's the unalias command in order to remove an alias. So let's say I wanted to get rid of the df alias. I can just type in unalias df. And now if I look at my aliases again, df is now gone from the list. But just be sure to know next time you do rerun bash, it will automatically reload that alias for df in because it's in our bash rc file. You can remove it permanently from the bash rc file and then it won't reappear back in here. Also remember, if you need to reload the current terminal's shell, you can do that by typing in source space and then .bashrc. Otherwise, that's it. If you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, please post them in the comments section below. Also, make sure to subscribe for future videos and make sure to like the video. Catch me in a great community on Discord, and I'll catch you in another video. Thanks for watching.